coming up. Our 12 Against Celebs are visited by the spirit of Christmas past.
We just hear me mum come to the bottom stairs and go, he's been...
Nothing else matters in December. It's Christmas.
We find out exactly what Yuletide memories are made of.
I feel like an adult now. I've gone and bought my mum a Christmas present.
You think sausage wrapped in bacon? Why is that so good? It just is.
Feeling festive?
It's Christmas!
I know he is. Have you ever wondered what Christmas was like for your favourite celebs when they were your age? What presents did they get? What Christmas Day telly did they watch? And what festive music made them move? Because despite the glamorous lifestyles they now lead, once they were an excited kid on Christmas Eve, just like you. This show revisits Christmas for our celebs and asks them to become 12 at Christmas again. They are some of the most mega famous stars in the world of showbiz.
Yes, I like it here.
From pop stars to presenters.
I'm Hayley, he's Ricky.
Actors. And DJs all are hugely successful.
Thank you, fans.
Brilliant.
But back when they were kids, they had the same kind of Christmas as me and you.
Your instant download for the week ahead.
So let's find out how our celebs felt when they opened that last door on their advent calendar. I know Sam gets excited. Jingle bell,
jingle bell, jingle bell. Christmas when I was 12, magic.
Any 12-year-old, Christmas is like a dream come true.
Your birthday and Christmas, I think, is what I used to live for. It's like your birthday, but it's everyone's birthday because everyone's sharing it at the same time.
It's the most exciting thing in the history of the world. There's no other way to say it. You absolutely adore it. You look forward to it. You count down to it.
Oh, the weather outside is frightful.
Christmas for me in my household has just always been just amazing. So I'm so, he'll tell you, still to this day, I get so excited about Christmas.
I love the excitement around it. I loved going shopping beforehand. I love putting the tree up, and it was a real family thing in our house, actually.
The great thing about Christmas was you could have a breakfast of chocolate. How wrong is that?
But before that special breakfast, there's the biggest night of the year.
Christmas Eve is my favourite night of the year. I love that night. It's so magic.
I can't sleep on Christmas Eve. I just sort of lie there and I'm like, right, Christmas is tomorrow. It's a few hours. It's a couple of hours. The one night of the year where I'm guaranteed to not get a single wink.
It was just magic. And most importantly, Santa Claus, you know? You just want that to last forever.
Don't worry, Ronan, the magic is just beginning. Now we know how excited our celebs used to be about Christmas, but what exactly did they get up to? Santa
Claus is coming to town. Christmas was quite embarrassing for me because my dad always loved to give out Christmas cards to our friends and our teachers, but they weren't just any regular Christmas cards. These were cards that had been made from our family holidays. They were like this big, strewn across it with all our faces going, Merry Christmas! Teachers loved it. Thought, oh, that's brilliant, that's so lovely. Merry Christmas from the Adubas. Oh, wasn't that nice? Yeah, whatever.
Me and brother went Christmas caroling. In the end, we raised like 60, 70 pounds. Me and brother thought, we're quids in here, like split it 50-50. We got it back and my dad's like, so you're going to put that in the collection tomorrow? And me and brother were like, pardon? It's like, yeah, you can put it in the mass collection tomorrow. And we're like, yeah. And so we ended up having to give it into the mass collection next day. But me and my brother, deep down, we just wanted to cry.
At least it went to a good cause, Kel. Bit of a shame, though, you could have spent it all on those all-important presents.
I remember going down to our local shopping centre in Bromley. I remember being given a bit of money and being like going to buy my mum a Christmas present. And that's when I was like... I feel like an adult now. I've gone and bought my mum a Christmas present.
I used to get all my family's presents from the ironmongers. I remember once I did the whole lot for £3.50. I got my sister a makeup brush for 49p, used. My other sister, I got a shoe polishing kit, used. And I got my mum and dad a set of six tumblers, all from the ironmongers. One-stop shop. What more do you want?
Yeah, Christmas sounds like a blast in your house, Dan. For some, though, it's the anticipation of what lies under the wrapping paper, which is the best thing.
The thing that ruined Christmas for me when I was 12 years old was my mum, for some reason, decided that we weren't going to open our presents until after Christmas dinner. I'm going to go for a lovely walk. So it used to sometimes be like 7 o'clock in the evening before I could open my presents, and my friends would be like phoning up telling me stuff they got, and I wouldn't know what I got because my mum wouldn't let us open our presents. And it's still like that as well. I think she just liked watching me like squirm.
For many though, Christmas is all about inviting their relatives over. Lots of them.
I've got a pretty big family, so Christmases are quite big. In fact, I remember one time my mum couldn't even fit everyone around the table. We had to get a tennis table and like put everyone around it, and my dad had to sit like in the corridor, like not even in on the table, because we've got that much of a big family.
On Christmas night, all my family would be together, so I took it upon myself, I was always a little bit loud then, to start doing impressions and singing and doing different things. So I put on a whole evening's entertainment and went round with the hat, and everyone started putting money in the hat. So I ended up with like £40 on Christmas night just from making everyone laugh. Rocking around
the Christmas tree. And it wouldn't be a proper Christmas without a serious amount of food.
Christmas dinner as well.
Oh,
glorified Sunday dinner.
The smell of turkey, because it used to go on the night before, that kind of Christmassy smell filled the whole house, and it was just fantastic.
Pigs in blankets. Whoever first came up with wrapping, essentially, pig in pig, it's brilliant. You think, sausage wrapped in bacon, why is that so good? It just is.
Why can't food be like that all the time?
You wouldn't appreciate it, Matt.
I would.
You wouldn't appreciate it, Matt.
I would.
You wouldn't appreciate it.
I really would. Jingle bell, jingle
bell, jingle bell. Right. Our Christmas dinner might be turkey with all the trimmings, but away from home, things are often a bit different. In Japan, they prefer to celebrate the big day with fast food style fried chicken. Another unusual festive tradition can be found in Iceland. Instead of Santa Claus, Christmas there coincides with the arrival of the Yule Lads, 13 trolls with names like Pot Scraper, Door Slammer and Window Peeper. Sounds a bit odd, doesn't it? But it's not a joke, honest. What's that? 12 Against the Best programme of all time? Cheers, lads. The Yule Lads enjoy causing mischief for the locals during the countdown to Christmas. But they also leave presents for the kids, so they're not all bad. He loves it. Away from the snow of Iceland, some parts of the world enjoy hot sunshine at Christmas. This may sound great, but it's not without its drawbacks, as one of our celebs discovered when he was a kid.
Christmas, of course, in Australia, is really, really hot. And I remember getting some chocolates from Santa, and they'd all melted under the Christmas tree. They were completely and absolutely melted, just all runny and gooey. It was grotesque.
Wow, so our celebs' festive memories are pretty unforgettable. But what music had them rocking around the Christmas tree?
For some reason, the charts at Christmas were always so important. I used to stay up listening to the radio, wanting to know what was going to be Christmas number one.
I think a Christmas number one needs some Jingle Bells, a chorus from a school choir, and definitely some Fake Snow.
Just put some sleigh bells in it, in my opinion.
Yeah,
you've got a Christmas song.
Apply the winning festive formula and you're left with a selection box of songs that provide the perfect Christmas soundtrack.
Last Christmas by Wham must have been around the time that I was 12. I loved that song. Last Christmas I gave you my heart, but the very next day you gave it away. I think it was, for me, the school disco and the idea that one Christmas, somebody could love you.
My favourite Christmas song of all time would definitely have to be The Pogues' Fairy Tale of New York. It's just such a good song.
Music-wise, the ultimate Christmas tune. Cliff! He's on the money. There's nothing wrong with Mistletoe and Wine. Logs on the fire, gifts on the tree. Time to rejoice in the good that we see. He's nailed it there. The big man's nailed it.
The only song I remember as a 12-year-old was White Christmas with Bing Crosby.
I'm dreaming of a white Christmas.
White Christmas was first heard by the public on Christmas Day in 1941, when Bing Crosby performed the song on the radio. It's been a massive Yuletide hit ever since, selling a whopping 50 million copies. That makes it the biggest-selling single of all time.
I used to do it in school for Christmas carols, and I absolutely loved that. I remember I used to, like, sing it all the time, thinking maybe we'll have a white Christmas this year, and we never did.
I don't know how he got away with going run, 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 run. Can't stand him.
Oh, come on, Chris, where's your festive spirit? Now, you couldn't talk Yuletide songs without paying tribute to the biggest Christmas cracker of them all.
The only song that comes into my head is Slade.
Are you ready?
It is the best song. It encapsulates the whole mood of Christmas.
Merry Christmas, Everybody was released in 1973 by glam rock legend Slade. It hit the top spot in December and stayed in the charts well into the new year.
It came straight in to number one, which was quite rare in those days for the charts. So every time you hear it, even now, it makes you feel happy. It makes you know that Christmas is there. As soon as that song is played, then it's time to actually celebrate Christmas.
It might be a Yuletide classic now, but Slade actually recorded the song in the middle of summer in New York. In the baking heat, how festive. Since first charting nearly 40 years ago, the song is now as much a part of Christmas as the Queen's Speech. And there's one line that everybody knows.
The most famous part of it, of course, is when Noddy Holder goes, "It's Christmas!
It's Christmas!"
As a kid, that's all you want to hear. That's what you want to scream to the rooftops when it's like...
That's what you shout when you leave school.
Absolutely,
It's Christmas!
Yes! Come on!
Spot on, lads. And if that's not got you feeling festive, just wait.